NLP Mastery, an approach to Neuro Linguistic Programming. Written by Robert Savage. Narrated by DMS. Many books have been written on NLP, Neuro Linguistic Programming. This short book is for people who have encountered the term NLP and want to know in simple terms what it is and what it does. One myth of NLP that you may have heard is NLP is therapy. Now, it is not. This confusion is understandable since many NLP techniques can and will be used in therapeutic practice. This is because NLP techniques can help improve brain functioning and enable the production of good brain chemicals. In this way, NLP techniques can be used as part of therapy to overcome phobias. However, knowledge of NLP can be just as effective. For example, to allow students to learn more effectively and elegantly. The use of NLP has spread over the years, and special techniques have been developed to help certain groups of people, e.g., students, athletes, workers, families, and so on. However, the growth and success of NLP now means that various skills and techniques can be used to improve all aspects of life. It is fair to say that some of the techniques were used to help people before NLP was developed. In those days, however, this was probably known as common sense, judgment, or intuition. The saying, "The map isn't the territory," can sum up a core concept of the NLP, because it underpins the differences between faith and reality. This means that each person works from a positive of objectivity rather than within their own perspective. NLP proponents agree that the understanding of the world by all is warped, constrained, and different. Therefore, a therapist who practices NLP must be able to see how a person receives his or her map and how this perception can affect his or her thoughts and behavior. The map of the world of a person consists of data received by the senses. This may be sensory, visual, olfactory, gustatory, or psychological. NLP practitioners believe that this information differs in quality and importance individually, and that each individual handles experiences using a primary representational system, RPS. To ensure that an NLP counselor works effectively with a client under treatment, the therapist must try to match the person's personal PRS. Practitioners in NLP assume that symbolic structures can be reached using stimuli such as eye movements. NLP counselors work with people to understand their behavioral and thought patterns, psychological condition, and goals. The therapist can help them find and strengthen the skills that best serve them by reviewing the map of a person and helping them to develop new strategies to replace unproductive ones. This process can help people achieve therapy goals. NLP supports claim that the technique works quickly, lastingly, and improves the comprehension of cognitive and behavioral trends. NLP is also trying to build effective communication between conscious and unconscious mental processes that can help people improve their imagination and solve problems. Some NLP proponents contrast the CBT approach, but say that positive changes in NLP may be achieved in less time. Traditional Gulf psychology techniques include positive thinking, visualization, and self-hypnosis. Many of these self-improvement methods were founded on the principles of the pioneering work in Hypnotist by Milton Erickson in the mid-70s and Neuro-Linguistic Programming by Richard Bandler and John Grinder. Forward-thinking Gulf psychology coaches have been using these techniques for years to eliminate tension and anxiety, increase confidence, and get golfers into the zone. These approaches work very well, and most of the successful PGA players use some variation of them every day. There exists, however, a darker and very devious way to use these same tools to your advantage on the course. that you can create a positive peak state in yourself, you can also sabotage your unknowing opponents by creating doubt, insecurity, and frustration within them at will. Sounds like fun, eh? Let's take anchors, for example. Traditionally, you would create an anchor to instantly put yourself into an emotional state, say a positive state of mind. You might simply imagine yourself in the past doing something incredibly well and feeling very confident. As you reach the peak of your confident state, you would do something unique, like tap your index finger and thumb together. After doing this several times, your brain will link up the action of touching those fingers together with a feeling of confidence. Then, all you need to do is perform that action on the course to feel confident. That's all well and good, but the really exciting thing is that you can also negatively anchor other players. For example, when your opponent misses a short putt and berates himself, it's obvious that he is in a negative mental state. At that moment, you can do something unique, like snap your fingers, hum a song, yawn. Almost everything that is unique and is easily duplicated, you've successfully set a negative anchor. Do that each time he flubs a shot, and the anchor will become even stronger. Fire that anchor off. Perform the unique action when your opponent is feeling fine, and watch what happens. Your opponent will return to that negative feeling associated with that anchor, and his performance will suffer. Now that's the dark side of golf psychology. What exactly does covert persuasion and hypnotism have to do with each other? First of all, we should start with mainstream hypnosis. That is the most common form, and most of us have seen it before. This is where a volunteer or group of volunteers go on stage and are hypnotized to think they are chickens. They cluck around on stage, and it can be very funny for everyone watching. It is what most people think of when it comes to hypnosis. There is another form of hypnosis that is much more persuasive and has been outlined from being used for advertising by businesses. This is called covert hypnosis, and you have probably never heard of this. Before we can understand the art of covert persuasion, you first need to understand the three basics of covert hypnosis strategy and the related science. There is hypnosis, neuro-linguistic programming, or NLP, and mentalism. Each of the three goes hand in hand to produce a discrete form of persuasion. Using these techniques, together they are extremely powerful and work without others knowing what is going on. Just learning any one of these techniques is amazing, but learning all three can be life-changing. Here are the basis of each of the three and the relationship to covert persuasion. No matter how discreet the guy is, this is often the case, and when this happens, you have effective, he lost control of the situation, and everything is left up to her. This is a situation that you want to avoid by not giving her this power. This means you shouldn't shower her with compliments, and you should act indifferent in her presence. While you should flirt with her, it should be done sparingly and with great care. Total mind control. One way to have total control over her mind is to use this technique called fractionation. This is a technique lifted from the field of NLP with a good mix of hypnosis. This technique is by far the best and most effective method to use, and although it can take some time to learn how to use properly, you will, however, find that it works on virtually every occasion. This is how you use the technique. Bring the girl through an emotional roller coaster in a conversation, and in the process, anchor her emotions with you. Fractionation is known to make women fall in love in 15 minutes or less, so it is indeed highly effective. Be aware of the consequences, however. It has been known to create stalkers out of women. But before you use this technique, you must heed this warning. Fractionation is considered a dark art tactic, which is the basis of hypnosis-based seduction. And while controversial, it is known to be one of the most effective tactics ever invented by underground seductionists. It is described in a step-by-step system in the Daily Seduction Manuscript. These psychology tactics are highly unconventional techniques that are used by the secret elite in the seduction community. Use it at your own risk. I vouch for the effectiveness of these tactics, but care must be taken as they could be outright dangerous in the hands of the unscrupulous. But if you're ready to get girls without breaking a sweat, then do this instead. Behavior to achieve better results than before in various walks of life. In a sense, neuro-linguistic programming can help you in many ways if only you get to know its techniques and how to use them for your benefit. I use NLP every day of my life as it allows me to learn new tasks at an alarming rate. NLP helps to strengthen my self-confidence and self-esteem. I always keep up a positive attitude and I can handle life's challenges in a more positive way. It works by identifying in others the essential characteristics, exceptional talent, successful attitudes, and empowering beliefs. The NLP helps you to learn them as well. Neuro-linguistic programming is the study of the structure of subjective experience. NLP was first developed in the early 1970s by an information scientist, Richard Bandler, and a linguistics professor, John Grinder. From their studies of successful people, they created a way to analyze and transform human excellence, resulting in the most powerful, practical psychology ever developed. NLP is a practical application of how people think, described as software for your brain. It allows you to automatically tap into the kinds of experiences you want and have. With NLP, you can create your future and you can have choices about your feelings, especially when it matters most. A state-of-the-art communications method for nurturing personal and professional growth, NLP creates an environment for graceful personal change. The fundamental principles of neuro-linguistic programming. The map is not the territory. We respond to our thoughts and memories. These are our internalized map of reality. However, these maps are not true reality. Experience has a structure. When we change the structure, the experience will automatically change. People work perfectly. People are always making the best choices available to them. People already have all the resources they need. Anyone can do anything. If one person can do something, anyone can learn to do that same thing. When there is a physical or environmental limit, the world of experience will let us know. Mind and body are parts of the same system. You cannot communicate. We are always communicating, at least non-verbally. Even thoughts are in communication with the self. The meaning of your communication is the response you get. Communication is not what is intended, but what is received. Underlying every behavior is a positive intention. The person or element with the most flexibility in a system will have the most influence. Neuro-linguistic programming gives you flexibility. There is no such thing as failure. It is feedback for the next step. Changed perceptions. You can turn to NLP when you are interested in developing your personality traits and characteristics, which determine your verbal and nonverbal reactions to the happenings in this world. As a first step, let us understand that your perception of reality is based on your subjectivity, just as a map is merely a miniature representation of a territory. What you perceive as real is only a colored representation of reality, not the reality itself. You can't help but look at the world through rose-colored glasses. Your reactions are dictated not by reality, but by your view of that reality. NLP helps you in realizing this and reducing, if not completely removing, your subjectivity. You will then consider adopting alternative viewpoints of reality and, consequently, bringing about a shift in the way you react to it. Why do people react differently to a particular event or situation? Is it not because of the differences in their perceptions of that event or situation? What a traumatic event is to one may not be the same to another. For instance, some people may take verbal or physical abuse lightly, or simply ignore it. Others may be so affected by it that they need psychological or medical treatment. The underlying philosophy of neuro-linguistic programming is based on the premise that it is possible to change one's perceptions, beliefs, and behavior so that traumatic experiences become possible to treat. It is also possible that you might even become immune to trauma. Get rid of phobias. You can similarly get rid of your phobias, if any, by going into the factors that cause your fear in the first place. With the help of NLP techniques, you can look at things in the way that your adversaries do. You can consider the same things from a new perspective, or you can study people who have achieved excellence in any particular aspect of their life, find out what qualities and factors contributed to their success, and then import the same or similar factors and qualities into your life in an effort to achieve excellence in your chosen field. Covert hypnosis is a powerful persuasion skill where a hypnotist can influence a subject without him or her knowing about it. Covert hypnosis is slightly different than stage hypnosis. There is no blatant trance that the subject is put in. Through simply pacing and leading the subjects with carefully chosen words and language patterns, the subliminal images, emotions, and messages the hypnosis wants to convey will simply sink into the subject's subconscious. Covert hypnosis is based on the work of Milton Erickson and further explained by the invention of NLP. Erickson was an expert at pacing his clients to build rapport and gradually leading them to where he wanted them to go. Erickson was also great at using various language patterns to get his clients the result they were looking for. This is the basis of covert hypnosis. To perform covert hypnosis, the hypnotist first has to get trust and rapport with the subject. Once the hypnotist has this trust, he can then lead with a pattern that conveys a subliminal message to the subject. Recently described as a modern branch of psychology, more specifically, it's a behavioral science comprised of most advanced studies in human behavior and the structure of thought, providing a deeper understanding of how people think and believe. Although NLP has been around for several decades, it still seems to be a resource that is relatively untapped by the general public. With numerous applications in healthcare, education, communication, business management, marketing, and sales, NLP seems to be a very powerful and versatile tool. However, it remains a wonder why more people are not utilizing this resource. The experience of NLP training has been described as life-changing, and its techniques offer a substantial advantage to most professions such as business executive managers, sales staff, customer service staff, receptionists and secretarial staff, administrators and human resource personnel, personal counselors, family therapists, professional life coaches, sports and athletic trainers and coaches, teachers, professors, and facilitators. NLP skills and techniques specifically help by making it possible for people to set clear goals and define realistic strategies, coach others to help them gain greater satisfaction for their job or their life, understand and reduce stress and interpersonal conflict, improve personal or professional relationships, improve sales performance, enhance customer care, and increase repeat business, improve people's effectiveness, productivity, and profitability, create greater understanding and learning abilities in others, guide others to understand and shift their behaviors. Some of the most contemporary thinkers of our time, such as Michael Lozier, author of The Law of Attraction, and Tony Robbins, author of Unlimited Power and Awaken the Great Giant Within, have used NLP to change their lives and now use it to help others do the same. Even the recently popular movie and book, The Secret, simply provide information that has been one small part of NLP training for the past 30 years. The training, NLP practitioner training techniques, you skills that allow you to better understand people's needs and how to help them get those needs in a way that will also get you what you want at the same time. The secrets for personal development. Personal development is a field that benefits everyone. The best techniques in personal development are kept secret and remain hidden for years. The NLP secret is part of the personal development secret that currently began hidden even after years it was discovered by someone. Some know the NLP secret and some do not. However, there is no doubt that it has advanced NLP techniques that most of us have not yet known. If we understand and apply the secret, we can instantly change our lives. NLP stands for Neuro Linguistic Programming. It is proven that our thoughts are influencing our life. So to change your life, we must change our thoughts. The concept is known as the law of attraction. According to the law of attraction, our life consists of our belief. Those beliefs are located in our minds. The NLP secret provides powerful methods to change our thoughts. How does it do that? It talks to our brain in its own language and alters our habitual thoughts that have taken root deep in our minds. Altering your minds can result in altering our lives. This concept, too, is known as the law of attraction. NLP secret methods are simple to follow. Though it is simple NLP techniques, it is advanced and changes our life faster than most methods in personal development. It is loved by people because it allows them to change their state of being and their life at any moment. Most of the parts that we want to improve in our life and self can be done using it. Using the NLP secret, it will work wonders, and many people that used it never thought it could change their life the way it has changed. They have tried multiple self-improvement techniques, and so they were so amazed the moment NLP Secret worked well and faster for them compared to any other personal development techniques. Who's driving the bus? We really don't take charge because few of us understand how our minds and brains work. We don't really know what photos, sounds, feelings, tastes, and smells our brains and minds have, let alone how this information affects us. This is the deal here. The brain works quite differently, storing data and keeping us alive. In contrast, the mind can focus more than just survival. It gives us the chance to create and choose a host of options. In this section, we will explore how our brains make the world sense, how to adjust that process, and how to deal with things that cause an emotional response and pull us off the course we want so our personal journey can navigate better. Where do you want to go? Outcome frames. Imagine this. Somebody comes in a taxi and the driver asks, "Where are you going?" And that passenger says, "Take me to the airport." It sounds silly, but how many of us are sailing our lives? It is difficult to get where we want to go if we don't know or understand where it is. Somewhere we don't want to be. It is easy to wind up and wonder how we got there, doesn't it? So first, we must know what we want. We need an outcome. You want it to be realistic, reasonable, and observable. It is easy to make a desire that is a personal social influence. Perhaps you wish a private jet, but perhaps what you really want is to travel easier. It is pretty costly to own and operate a personal jet, and there are many other simple ways to travel. One of the most relevant NLP mechanisms is the outcome frame, because it deals with the elements that make for a meaningful goal that really benefits you. Leslie Cameron, one of NLP's co-developers, explains it like this. The outcome frame is a set of questions that direct your thinking to optimize your chance to get what you want. It is indeed an orientation, a way to perceive experience as a number of choices. Instead of grappling with why a problem exists, it organizes knowledge around what is expected and how it can be accomplished. In the NLP, there is an ongoing presumption that if something can be done by a person in the world, it is possible for anyone. It is only a matter of how. The outcome framework's why orientation helps you to transform the inevitable failures and difficulties you encounter into valuable feedback. As long as you have a specified outcome that you maintain and know it can be achieved, a reversal is simply something on your way to your outcome. The things that you do lead you to your outcome, let you know that you are on the right path. Those who are deceptive only show that what you do to achieve your results is not helpful, and you have to change your approach. When I came to use the well-formed tests, I wondered how I could ever do without them. It's so simple and efficient that you can use it for whatever you want. It is especially helpful when you plan big changes, get stuck, or just want to smooth out a target you have or are pursuing. Let's review the main questions and conditions of a well-formed outcome, and then you can apply them to your desired outcome by using a simple worksheet. The well-formed results include the following six questions, which we will examine one by one, using the goal of feeling more convincing. What specifically do you want? How will you know when you've achieved what you want? Under what circumstances, where, when, and with whom do you want to have this result? What stops you from having your desired outcome already? What resources will you need to help you create what you want? How are you going to get there, and what's the first step to begin achieving this result? Cognitive behavioral therapy has many positive results or outcomes that are much efficient for someone's mind production. A CBT helps a lot to overcome different disorders and sources of tensions as well as their terrible results. Some of the most terminating and prominent results of CBT I've given below. Effectiveness, pros and cons of CBT, advantages, disadvantages. Effectiveness. CBT has been effective treatment for many psychiatric conditions. In a meta-analysis of controlled trials, Lynch et al. Found CBT in 2010 to be an effective intervention in the treatment of depression. CBT can help you deal with problems such as anxiety and depression and reduce your chances of having a negative impact on your life. There is always the risk that you will return to the bad feelings associated with your problem, but with your CBT skills, you should be able to overcome them. Analysis. 269 meta-analysis studies and reviewed 106 mega-analyzed samples from representatives who examined CBT for the following issues: substance use disorder, schizophrenia and other psychiatric disorders, depression and dysthymia, bipolar disorder, anxiety disorders, somatoform disorders, eating disorders, insomnia, personality disorders, anger and aggression, criminal behavior, general stress, general medical condition, distress, chronic pain and fatigue, and pregnancy complications. Proofs and results. Additional meta-analysis studies examined the efficiency of CBT for various problems in children and older adults. The strongest support is for CBT for anxiety disorders, somatoform disorders, bulimia, anger control problems, and general stress. 11 studies compared response rates between CBT and other treatment or control conditions. However, additional research is needed to test the efficiency of CBT for randomized control studies. In addition, no meta-analysis studies of CBT have been reported on examples of specific subgroups, such as ethnic minorities and low incomes, in addition to the population of children and the elderly. Efficiency. A class of interventions are referred by cognitive behavioral therapy, which explains the basic premise that mental disorders and psychological distress are maintained by cognitive factors. The basic premise of this therapeutic approach, as Beck 1970 and Ellis 1962 do, is to believe that feelings of disorder are helpful in managing emotional distress and behavioral problems. According to Beck's model, these disturbances comprise general beliefs about the world, self, and future, or schemes which give rise to specific and automatic thoughts in certain situations. Since these initial designs, a number of disorderly CBT protocols have been developed that specifically focus on various factors related to the cognitive and behavioral care of various disorders. Medical model of psychology, MMP. According to the medical model of psychology, the overall goal of treatment is reduction of symptoms, improvement in functioning, and relapse of the disorder. As such, modern CBT refers to a family of interventions that combine a variety of academic, behavioral, and emotional-oriented techniques. Pros and cons of CBT. There are several advantages and disadvantages associated with CBT. CBT can also be completed in a relatively short period of time compared to other treatment options. Also, of the same nature of CBT, it may not be suitable for people with more complex mental health needs or learning difficulties. Advantages of CBT. Research has shown that CBT can be just as effective in treating many types of depression and other mental health disorders. CBT can be completed in a relatively short period of time compared to those other types of interaction therapy. The highly organized nature of CBT means that it can be provided in a variety of formats, including groups, self-help books, and computer programs. The skills you learn in CBT are useful, practical, and helpful strategies. They can be incorporated into everyday's life, which helps you better deal with future pressures and problems. Following are some advantages of cognitive behavioral therapy. Short duration of treatment, effective as medication, different therapies, inheritance, real-world skills, collaborative effort, no age restriction, cost-effective approach. Short-term duration of treatment. CBT doesn't take much time to complete compared to other types of talk therapy. Patients who undergo cognitive behavioral therapy usually meet for individual sessions that last up to 30 minutes, depending on the issues involved, up to 60 minutes. You visit your physician once a week or once every other week, depending on the situation involved. Effective as meditation. This is just as effective as medicine for treating some mental health disorders. Symptoms of this health problem include loss of interest in things you already enjoy, low energy levels, physical illness development, and isolation. Different therapies inherent with it. Various types of therapy sessions and tools are available through CBT. Communication is one of the most common ways to begin engaging with academic behavioral therapy. Multiple tools are available for patients to use while also adjusting their thinking patterns. The different types of therapy sessions and tools available through CBT are intended to help you work in ways that make you feel natural and comfortable. Real-world studies. The skills learned through CBT session offers real-world skills. When you are working with an academic behavioral therapist, what you are doing is a skill-based practice. Identifying your competitive strategies that you can use in any situation you find yourself. The skills learned through each CBT session are real-world skills. This identification of coping skills method makes it possible for you to deal with chronic self-esteem, high stressful situations, or difficult situations as you understand the bigger picture through CBT. Collaborative effort. CBT is a collaborative effort. When going through academic treatment, your therapist will not tell you what to do. They will work with you to find solutions to these problems right now. Because of CBT is a collaborative effort, there is a greater accountability for this process. When you have peers, you are much more likely to succeed. No age restrictions. CBT is useful for almost any age group. Children and adults benefit from intellectual behavioral therapy when used properly. Expectations are the same across any age group, as long as one has the ability and desire to make changes in one's life. CBT offers a solution that can cure existing problems. CBT is a way to build trust in others and yourself while working to break down the negatives and their destructive effects in life. Cost-effective approach. While CBT was initially more expensive to provide, the overall cost of medication continued until the end of the first year of follow-up. In addition, mindfulness-based CBT is a particularly cost-effective method, as it is offered in a group format. Disadvantages of cognitive behavioral therapy. A therapist can give you help and advice, but without your help, you cannot solve your problems. Just as CBT has innumerable benefits, some of its disadvantages are listed, which are as follows. Dependent to patient's will. Long-term duration and extra sessions. Non-effective on complex mental health. Inverse feeling results. Focuses on individual capacities. Not useful in specific learning difficulties. Dependent to patient's will. Cognitive behavioral therapy depends on the patient's will. Each person has to invest in themselves to make academic behavior therapy work. During a therapy session, you will be asked what you expect to work you are doing. If you are not ready to make any plans or work on homework for the next session, the results of your CBT experience will be limited. Everyone participating in academic behavior therapy must fully cooperate with this process to produce results. Long-term duration and extra sessions. CBT takes a long time to complete with extra work between sessions. Homework is arguably the most important element of academic behavioral therapy. Most work requirements include practicing new skills for the first time during a therapy session. Over time, coping strategies are also developed and implemented in the reconstruction of destructive belief systems. Non-effective on complex mental health. People with complex mental health needs may not even benefit from CBT. CBT works to restructure issues such as anxiety by changing how thoughts are implemented. With complex phobias or mental health concerns, CBT is not useful because there are certain risk factors that are sometimes applied. Take someone who's afraid of flying, for example. According to some statistics, flying is safer than driving, yet if an aircraft falls by 30,000 feet, you are 100% killed. Some people walk away from high-speed collisions. In the airplane, you can be statistically safer, but if an incident happens, the person with the phobia says they are statistically more secure in an automobile. Being aware of ideas is not always a guarantee that improvement is made. Inverse feelings result. Cognitive behavioral therapy often makes people feel worse before they get better. CBT requires individuals to cope with problems that cause them difficult feelings. It is not normal for physical actions to be worse. Someone who is struggling with isolation and can eat his own copies regularly checks the refrigerator for breakfast during this phase. Focuses on individual capacities. It focuses on the individual's ability to change. People should be prepared to change the way behavioral therapy works properly. CBT should also have an individual ability to change to offer useful results. Recommended tools for homework, group sessions, or one-to-one therapy must be offered to the patient for availability for regeneration utilities. Without this access, nothing happens. Not useful in specific learning difficulties. CBT is not useful for people with specific learning difficulties. Experimental therapy is the basic form that behavioral therapy uses to create and treat people with specific learning difficulties. By taking a hands-on approach, the challenges involved in the individual involved can be overcome in practice. Would you like to know the advantages of NLP? Are you trapped in a mental grid? Restart your brain now with a fantastic NLP workout. NLP is the science for understanding the brain information processing system. NLP reads as Neuro Linguistic Programming. The NLP techniques, therefore, helps to understand the interaction of neurological and linguistic skills. The human brain is made up of neurons, and these neurons can be programmed and reprogrammed accordingly, using NLP training techniques and principles. NLP works according to two basic principles. All NLP models work under the following two conditions. 1. Mind and life are systematic processes. This principle states that all the processes that take place within the human body, which take place between people and the entire environmental system, are logical and systematic. One part of the system cannot be isolated from the other. 2. The map is not the territory. By uniqueness, people tend to imagine only perceptions of reality and not reality itself. The principle seeks to help a person distinguish between a menu and a meal. Help a person understand thoughts and things as they are. All in all, a person's technique helps expand the neuro-linguistic map. NLP is science and art at the same time. An attempt is made to put the collective facts into practice. Without this practical application, NLP training has no meaning. NLP is a way to discover yourself while mastering hidden negative attitudes and beliefs. Technology has been a blessing for millions of people who have completed NLP training and managed to overcome their unexplained fears and beliefs. NLP's extraordinary techniques have helped them enrich their personal and professional relationships and increase their trust. We will look at some of the most common applications here: seduction, enhancement of confidence, building relationships, lies detection, phobia.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.